And I spoke earlier to India's golden girl. Yes, of course she's golden, even though she won a bronze. Saina Nehwal joins me. And Saina Nehwal, first I have to ask you, after the years and years of practice for this medal, are you finally having a break? Are you finally relaxing?
Yeah, took for almost 1.5 days. Really happy, enjoying my time, and came back with such a good medal. So really enjoying this time. Really never expected that I did actually. It's a little like a dream come true. Something which is unbelievable, and getting the first medal for India in badminton is great. I really want to take badminton in a great, in a new height, and really want to make it a popular sport, and very happy that I'm doing it and finally getting a medal for my country, for my parents, for my coaches is, such, I think I just made everyone's dream come true. So it's such a happy moment for me.
All the dedications there, what about your dream? I know for one that you said that all you want was some pizza and chocolates. Are you finally being allowed to eat that? Because you had to lose 5 kilos before you played in the Olympics at this time. You had got much fitter.
Everything. I'm having everything right now. It's a time to indulge a lot. So I'm not taking any kind of, good food. I'm only having junk from last 1.5-2 days. So it's, of course, the time to enjoy. So just want to enjoy for some more days and be fresh and get ready for training again, because it's going to get really tough from now on. There will be a lot of expectation and pressure for me, but I just want to train hard, be fit, and perform the same way, for the next tournaments.
So enjoy the break, Saina. But tell me, it must have been interesting for you back away from all the pressure and watching MC Marie Kom fight it out. She said sorry to the nation. And that's, I think, a sign of the pressure that all of you must be under with the huge expectations that we all have. What would you like to say on Marie Kom?
I think, first of all, I would like to congratulate her for her victory. She doesn't have to be sorry, because she's done a great job. First time, I think, women boxing was in Olympics, and she got a medal for the country. So, it's a huge thing. She's a five-time world champion, and now she's won a medal for the country. So, of course, we all are so proud of her. I was actually expecting her to get the gold, but, anyway, she's done fantastically well for us, and of course there's a lot of pressure on all the players, because they work hard so much, and finally it's like a final exam for us, and people expect so much from all the players, and finally to live up to the expectation, it's always tough, but we do a lot of things, players are always very strong mentally and physically, so of course we need to be more confident, more focused, and more determined. So we do a lot of things to be focused and not to really think about that so much, and
of
just
course
to perform for the country.
Mm-hmm. But tell me, who is your favorite athlete at the Olympics? Because in a sense, also just being at the Olympics, watching and being part of the same games that international athletes like Usain Bolt or Michael Phelps are all there. What was your wow moment really meeting or watching which event at the Olympics?
Actually, I just like to watch all the top players playing. It's not like I have anyone favorite. Of course, Roger Federer is my favorite player, but I like watching swimming. I like watching athletics. I like watching all the sports, whoever is doing well. Of course, I watched Michael Phelps winning the gold. I watched Usain Bolt winning the gold in 100 meters. So I watched, all the players doing well. So it's just that, I love all the players who do well in the Olympics, and I just would like to watch all the sports. There's no favorite, it's just that who's winning the that particular sport, I just want to watch them and feel proud, because there's someone who's standing in the in that podium, and I just want to see all those three medal winners winning it, and see their feelings, how they enjoy it. So that's what I like the most.
Also, Saina, we have questions for you from our viewers on ndtv.com who've written in, and Karthik Chandrasekhar has written in asking that, given the talent pool in India now with Kashyap, Jwala, Punappa, what outlook do you have, and will you ever actually be in doubles, or are you only going to focus on singles?
No, actually, I'm doing so well in singles. I don't see myself as a doubles player ever, but I'm so happy that the other players did really well. Kashyap played excellently well in Olympics. He is the first male player to reach quarterfinals, and I saw his matches. He was playing really well with all the top players, and he beat most of them quite easily. So it was a great tournament for him as well. And Jwala Ashwini, I can say that it was just a bad day for them on with the Japanese players. Otherwise, they were playing really, really well. I was expecting them to win and get into the quarterfinals, because from then on, you know, when that whole controversy happened and they really had a chance to win a medal for the country, I think it was again really unlucky for them. But otherwise, I think they were in their best shape. Both of them worked very hard, and they have a great future. Of course, all of them work really hard, so I know in the future they will win many things.
Right, and Saina, Venkat Gandhi wants to ask, how, what would you ask the government, parents, and especially given the young of India, to get more people to play badminton and more medals? When will we have many Sainas coming up?
It can happen. You see, China won 5 gold medals in badminton, so even India can do that. We have a lot of talent. I can just say that you know, parents should be supportive. A lot of sponsors should come in each and every sport, not only in badminton. It's important that the kid who really wants to play any sport should be very much hardworking, should be disciplined, and should have a lot of you know, determination to do well at the highest level. And because I have seen many kids, they're like, they just play for some time and they get bored and then they go back study and all that. But there should be something like sports school, and they should only be thinking about the sports, and then you can see the results coming out. But there should be equal amount of backing up from the sponsors, from you know, from the coaching side, from the infrastructure side. And I can assure you that, you know, you can see a lot of change in all the sports in India.
Saina Nehwal, thanks so much for joining us tonight.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.